Greetings and welcome to another Sims 4 reveal trailer of some kind here on LGR. And this is the Build Mode official gameplay trailer narrated by John Burgess. Well, it would be, except it's now narrated by me, because I'm a YouTuber and that's what we do. That makes this original content. Anyway, with the reveal of the Create-A-Sim trailer not too long ago that we previously covered on LGR, I know a lot of us were actually hoping to see the Build Mode one come soon, and here it is. That's good. I was really hoping you'd be able to build things in this game, but, you know, with EA, you never know. Ha! Jokes! Lols. Let's go ahead and take a look at this actual content here that they're revealing. They started out by making a house from scratch for Bella and Mortimer Goth. And at the very beginning, they actually show what looks like placing of primitives, instead of just being able to place down walls or walled-in rooms. These actually have some different shapes. Now, there's still no completely round walls, dang it. But it's neat that you can actually just place these things down, get some sort of base shape of a house, overlap them, and click and drag them to your heart's content, and then also be able to place what looks very similar to the blueprints mode from The Sims 3. You can just place different styles of different types of rooms right there in the house, and then also click and drag those walls, and then the contents of those rooms will actually be snapped to the walls and moved and scaled as you change things around to however you like, which, man, that's really cool. You couldn't do that in The Sims 3's blueprint mode. And although you can choose from a few select pre-made styles and, of course, like custom wallpaper and stuff, it doesn't look like the creative style is in here at all, as pretty much confirmed by the last video and things that I've been reading online since then, and that sucks. Whatever, maybe they've got something else as a replacement for that. We will just have to see, because they're not saying much on it. But yeah, this clicking around and just sort of automated system for making more complex styles of rooms, it seems like that's kind of the thing with The Sims 4. Not only in Create a Sim can you just click wherever you want and drag it and move things around to make things more customized, but you can do the same thing here with floor plans and walls and even the height of the walls. There are three heights that you can choose from, and that's really cool. That's something that's been asked for a very long time. Not just half walls, but you know, you got like regular walls and really freaking tall walls, and it looks like everything else scales to that. Or at least the wallpaper does. It does not appear that windows and the curtains and things like that that are on the walls actually scale with those walls. There is this new window adding feature so that windows are actually automatically placed there, so it doesn't look like it's going to be as big of a pain to replace all of these windows, just do it in one click. There are some new outdoor like flourishes and decor touches though, which is pretty cool. You have all these pillars that you can just place right there in the railings, as well as these decorative overhangs right below the eaves on the roof. And possibly even things like gable decorations and whatnot. All of these different trim options really do make a house look more believable, or at least more fancy. I'm still secretly hoping for my lower middle class and hungry hobo content, but whatever, this is really cool stuff. I mean, look at this roof molding and whatnot. You can make these crazy looking roofs that look like something straight off of Aladdin's palace. And a little bit more on-the-fly adjustment of things like foundation heights, which can be adjusted to, looks like, three different heights as well. You don't have to set that in stone beforehand. In stone, because it's like a stone foundation. Honestly, all of this build mode stuff looks pretty frickin' awesome so far. And I also like the fact that you can actually take entire buildings and move them around on the lot without having to just get all pissed off at everything because you placed something like one tile over to the left that you should have had to the right. And then you gotta like move everything over. Man, that was such a pain in every other Sims game so far. And I also just like the environment that this appears to be taking place in. It appears that there are actually like pathways winding in and around these houses, and it's not just like a road in front of your house. Some of the houses are sort of catty-cornered in there as well, like they're placed towards these pathways instead of just towards the road. It makes it look like a more believable housing development that everything is placed in. You also have what appears to be an actual working, moving tram out in front in the road. There's like a split roadway there. There's an island in the middle, and you got that tram going down. I hope you can actually use that thing, because that would be cool. As for the actual gameplay, though, man, we are still kind of lacking on what in the world that's actually going to be like. I mean, I assume it's going to be just like The Sims, right? But with more multitasking and whatever more emotion they decide to put in here. Well, anyway, that is it for The Sims 4 Build Mode reveal. And once again, it's pretty much just what they have shown so far, just in more detail and with a supposedly more finalized build of the game. In fact, it looks like they're still going through some iterations of this, because if you look down here, you can actually see the UI change subtly throughout this demonstration of this build mode gameplay, so I don't know. I mean, they're constantly tweaking things, and we're just gonna have to wait until it comes out. Not only that, but look at this. It looks like there's a button for chairs and rooms with chairs. Glad to see they're still keeping chairs such an integral part of the Sims experience. But yeah, feel free to continue watching LGR. I'll update on whatever else comes out, if anything else comes out. I'm sure E3 is gonna have a bunch of junk. And as always, I've got a crap load of videos coming between now and then. So feel free to subscribe if you would like more, or just go and check out my previous Sims 4, Sims 3, Sims 2, Sims 1, Sims City, Sim Ant, Sim whatever the frick else is on my channel. It's all there. There's also Twitter, Facebook, Patreon, and my refrigerator, but I'm keeping that to myself because I've got good food in there. Namely, leftover pizza at the moment. I am gonna go eat that. Thank you for watching.